I don't know. Which policy is the right one? Are you sure you've got one of half a million? Or maybe just a small one then? Mum, can I tell you? Why would I want to be drinking coffee at this time of night? Enough trouble sleeping as it is. It's only 7:30. I don't know. How am I supposed to tell which one is the right one? They've all got the same number on them. How am I supposed to know which one is the right one?
I don't think you need to worry too much about those. If I remember correctly, Dad's pension was index-linked, so they're probably just updates telling you how much the pension was worth at the time.
I've read this paragraph 3 times now. How am I supposed to concentrate with you littering on? Sorry.
I had it, it was nice. Brian wrote the chips with his, but I just had a bit of brain crock.
I'm arranged to see the vicar at 10 tomorrow.
Yes, you said.
Are you coming with me?
Of course I'm coming with you. Why wouldn't I?
So I need to buy my head off. Susan, I don't know what it is with you, but you hardly said a civil word to me since you got here.
I hardly said a civil word to you. I was barely through the front door when you started having a go at me.
Well, if you'd got here when you were supposed to, we wouldn't have had to rush into town.
There was an accident on the motorway. How many times do I have to tell you?
Maybe I will have some coffee.
Well, you could have phoned.
I did phone. You said you couldn't hear me and hung up.
Well, I couldn't. You sounded as if you were shouting at me from the bottom of a well.
I was on hands-free.
Well, you could have stopped at the service station and used a proper phone.
Yes, of course. Because they keep a special lane clear in a 6-mile tailback just so people can get off the motorway and phone their mothers.
I'll just help myself, shall I?
So all the thanks you get for doing your best and making a nice home for your family.
Oh, for goodness sake.
I mean, you're obviously ashamed of the place. You haven't brought a boyfriend home in years.
I haven't lived here in years.
We don't know what you're up to from 1 week to the next.
I could make tea, Margaret, if you prefer.
So, you're always swanning off with your fancy friends. There's always me who has to pick up the phone. I'd have liked to have gone to drama school. No, I had to stay home, look after your Aunt Lillian.
I wouldn't have minded staying on my own.
We were lucky they were able to see us down at the co-op. We were meant to have been there at 12. I think you're more interested in that play of yours than your own father's funeral.
I've said I'm sorry. I thought I'd left in plenty of time. Obviously, I was wrong.
Oh, not that funny. It hasn't stopped all day.
Do you want me to get it?
Yes. Will you tell them that I'm having a lie down and to call back tomorrow?
No. Do you think we could just try to?
I'm thinking of having all things bright and beautiful and the Lord's my shepherd at the church. What do you think?
I think we should talk.
Well, I was thinking of asking you, Uncle Dennis, to do the reading.
Mum, why won't you?
The cars are coming here at 9:30, so we need to make sure we're...
I'm sorry. It's Dennis. I want to know if he's doing the reading on Thursday.
Well, I don't know. I was half thinking of asking Tom Arnold.
Seems pretty keen to talk to you.
Just tell him I need to think about it and that I'll give him a phone tomorrow.
Well, couldn't you just... I'll tell him.
What are you going to hide behind after Thursday?
Such a shame you never saw a grandchild.
Good one, turn it back on me again.
Would you like to put a grandson? He could have taken him shooting with him at the weekend.
Why won't you talk to me?
But I suppose you're never going to meet Nick Winnington, a normal man, are you? I mean, was hanging around with them actors. You're hardly going to find yourself a proper man. I mean, even if they start out normal, they end up that way. Look what they did to Rock Hudson.
For God's sake! My father is dead! Your husband is dead! And all you seem to care about...
I'm going to go and talk to you, Uncle Dennis. I mean, Lillian will only end up saying something she shouldn't.
Oh! Please don't go away just because you refuse to acknowledge them, you know!
Here is the 6 o'clock news. The Shah of Iran's ambition to make oil-rich Iran the 5th most powerful country in the world hit a setback yesterday when protest erupted in the Iranian capital.
It's not like in the olden days. They're all done in hospitals now. It would be like murdering my own baby.
Well, you should have thought about that before you...
Before you put yourself into this mess, keep your voice down. Susan's upstairs.
Don't you tell me to keep my voice down in my own house.
I'm sorry, I don't know what I'm saying, but if Susan finds out...
Susan will never find out. No one will ever find out.
Not even...
No! If you say one word about this to anyone, you'll never step foot inside this house again. Do you hear me?